don't know about this, it's been over 1 year since I've been making these creepypasta and game reviews, and I figured I should talk about another Poképasta, because not only was my first one Pokemon Black, this one was even shorter to make! Given that this is the shorter version of the Lavender Town Syndrome story, many details are left out, like Buried Alive and the White Hand. So for this short pasta, it's an interesting little story about the music for Lavender Town and Pokemon Red and Green when the games were released in Japan back in 1996. I've never really heard of a song with high frequencies that could cause kids to possibly kill themselves. I'm not sure how this would work, but then again, I'm not a doctor or a scientist, so at least I have an excuse. What's yours? Apparently back in 2010, someone used some special software to work on the Lavender Town soundbite and saw weird messages in the music itself. I call bullshit on that. Anyway, if this pasta was true, there would have been actual reports of children committing suicide back then. Even if Nintendo had covered it up, people could always get the original cartridges, hack into them, and try to find the original version of the Lavender Town theme song. Well, some have, but I call hooey on them with their videos anyway. So with that knowledge, let's get off of this Poképasta so I can get back to working on my 1 year anniversary video. What the video is though, well, you're gonna have to wait to see it like everyone else, otherwise it wouldn't be a secret. Son of a bitch, who's been messing around with my video?
The Lavender Town Syndrome, also known as Lavender Town Tone, or Lavender Town Suicides, was a peak in suicides and illness of children between the ages of 7 and 12 shortly after the release of Pokemon Red and Green in Japan, back in February 27, 1996. Rumors say that these suicides and illnesses only occurred after the children playing the game reached Lavender Town, whose theme music had extremely high frequencies that studies show not only children and young teens can hear, since their ears are most sensible. Due to the Lavender Tone, at least 200 children supposedly committed suicide, and many more developed illnesses and afflictions. The children who committed suicide usually did so by hanging or jumping from heights. Those who did not act irrationally complained of severe headaches after listening to Lavender Town's theme. Although Lavender Town now sounds different depending on the game, this mass hysteria was caused by the first Pokemon game released. After the Lavender Tone incident, the programmers have fixed Lavender Town's theme music to be at a lower frequency, and since, children were no longer affected by it. One video appeared in 2010 using special software to analyze the music of Lavender Town's music. When played, the software created images of the unknown near the end of the audio. This raised some controversy since the unknown Pokemon didn't appear to the Generation 2 games, Silver, Gold, and Crystal. The unknown translates to "leave now." There is also the said beta version of Lavender Town. It is said that the beta version of Pocket Monsters was released to some kids to test the games.